further elaborate now. So firstly we had adjectives of origin, then we saw adjectives of color, then before that even we had seen adjectives of quality. Now let us see what is the next slide. Can you see your broad shoulders? Shoulders are being referred by a lot. Let's go to the next slide. I will now request Patil sir to read his slide loudly for us.
Adjectives of quantity, numbers are also adjectives. They tell us how many. 11 eggs, 15 frogs, 19 lizards, 12 geese, 16 snakes, 20 butterflies.
20 butterflies. Many a times you put a number and that behaves as a adjective. As Madam sometime back told about 10 centimeter scale. Give me a 10 centimeter scale. Length of the scale is 10 centimeter. Length of the scale is 10 centimeter. Can I give you more Indian examples of this? There are 11 sons, there are 12 Rudras. There are 11 sons, 12 Rudras, 3 goddesses. And you can tell me the names also. As per our mythology and culture, we know there are 11 sons, there are 12 Rudras, there are 3 goddesses. Correct or not? So many examples are there. These are numbers are behaving as adjectives. The moment you are told something that you already know, the moment you are told something that you already know, then only there is enlightenment kind of thing. And you catch that knowledge very close. So whenever you want to reach to the audience, one common rule is tell them what they already know, then take them to what they don't know. Because our psychological neuroscience process is like that. Whatever new thing we learn is only by what we have already learned. We always make a connect to what is already known. Psychologically, philosophically, say that.
Psychologically.
People never learn new things. They always relate to old things. Are you getting this? So remember, this as a pedagogic trick. They never learn new things. They always relate with the old thing. That is how our neurons work. Is that okay? So there are some more examples on this adjectives of quantity. I have given you local examples of 11 sons, 12 Rudras, 3 goddesses, and there will be 14 lokas. As per our mythology, there are 14 lokas, 3 places, and many more examples you can find on that. Yes?
Dozen bananas.
Okay. Now, there is a miracle of magic happening today. 10 centimeter scale, Madam mentioned in the last adjective. Now, what sir has mentioned, dozen, is not exactly a number, but it is still indicating some number. That slide is coming up next. A dozen bananas. Next.
We have one buffalo.
This animal has been visiting our class since long. We have one buffalo. That's an example. Normally, say that.
Normally.
Adjective of quantity will be big number. And noun will come as plural. But only when we use the number one, we have to be careful that noun is in singular form. In singular, I have only 1 rupee coin left in my pocket. I have only 1 rupee coin left in my pocket. 1 rupee coin. I have 20 coins in my pocket. Are you getting? 20 coins in my pocket. Next, more examples from your end, please. Therefore, sir, I will request to give us a sentence. He's struggling hard on the last page to see what is there on the slide.
There are 20 students in batch.
There are 20 students in a batch. In a batch of students. Again, you can say that. 20 has become adjective. More examples. Yes, you can create one example for us. What happens to you whenever I point out to you? An energy, right? There is an energy in our belly that gushes right to the head. Mukti mil jati energy ko pura. Yes or no? Kitne log agree karte? This is how you should do in your class. But look, they should feel it respectable. They should not feel it like an insult. एक अपनापन से होना चाहिए then they will enjoy it. Are you getting? So unless you have a rapport with the class, whenever you go to a new stranger's class, don't do this. They will find you as a Hitler. Are you getting what I'm saying? Yes. There are seven colors in the rainbow. That's a wonderful sentence, madam and everyone. You will always remember this and answer to your quantity, and there is no objection to that. It is universal truth. Some of the sentences are debatable and some are universal truth. See, universal is adjective. Debatable is also adjective. Without these words, my statement would have been very incomplete. What I said, there are some statements debatable and certain are universal truths. Correct? No? So how much importance is there to adjectives, you can guess. Had I not used the word debatable and had I not used the word universal, this sentence would be incomplete or punchless. Incomplete or lacking the punch. Correct? Yes, more examples.
I
drink 4 liter water in a day. 4 liter. 4 has become the adjective of quantity. You should drink a lot of water. That is true. See, next time I have said you should drink a lot of water. That lot of word is not telling exact number, but it also adjective. As sir said, dozen bananas. Dozen doesn't indicate directly the number. Indicates, but doesn't use the number directly. These are also adjectives. Yes. I read 2 books in a week. She tried to say, I read a 2 books in a week. So there is a non-understanding where she will use a. If you are using the number 2, it will not be book, it will be books. The moment you correct it, you will start developing the confidence. You will make correct it only when you understand A should not be used because there are 2. And the moment you use 2, you should use not book but books. Now the moment you capture this concept, many of your future sentences will be correct. Am I right or not? So whenever there is a single entity, use the word a, don't use the plural form. And whenever you use 2, don't use the word a, and it should be in the plural form. 2 books, a book. 2 books, a book. They always go hand in hand. Don't use a 2 books. That will be something too much. Correct? Next. No, you are too much of comfortable. I will request sir to give the sentence.
Sachin
Tendulkar has scored 100 centuries in the match. Somebody told you this sentence was there in the morning batch also. So it's a pure repetition. Automatically it got repeated. So both batches are going very synchronous. Century 100 is the adjective of quantity. One more? Yes. Okay, sir, can you give one sentence?
I have 2 pairs of shoes.
I have
2 pairs of shoes.
I have 2 pairs of shoes. I have 2 pairs of shoes. So the word 2 is the adjective of quantity. The word 2 is an adjective of quantity. Can we clap for this adjective?